and see me. I've discovered something in the locket we found at Gringotts.
Lumos. Lumos.
I go to Gringotts, do I get some sniveling wizard telling me you frittered away half our fortune on the sweets trolley?
Leviosa! Revelium. Lumos. Revelium.
Madame Kagawa said you'd never do anything.
You stay in your portrait, and I'll stay in mine.
Revelium.
Please, we are making
you make a point. Get away from me.
Revelio.
Here I've come from the toilet bowl where she said I could swim, did you praxia mole? As long as 'twere only one time per week, I can plunge the boy's lavatory. Not for the meek.
Please, Peeves, you'll make me late.
He tried to stop me, did rancorous carp, sought to trap me, confine me inside of a jar. But he failed, as did his containment charms, so I took my revenge to wreak havoc and harm. It was granted my privileges, be handsome and easy, or I'd fire up
Leviosa.
A cannon, and so she agreed.
Accio.
I had a contract with her, not with him, that if I behaved, I'd have one weekly swim! Whee!
I'll get you for this.
Revelio.
Professor, I'm glad to see you.
And I you. Thank Merlin you're in one piece. I heard about the attack. Trolls in Hogsmeade?
Sir, the trolls were wearing armor. It had that dark glow like the dragon collar.
Goblin silver! Ranrok used it to control the dragon. But how? And why send trolls to...
They were there because of me. I overheard Ranrok talking with Victor Rookwood.
Ranrok was in Hogsmeade, with Rookwood.
The trolls were Ranrok's distraction so that Rookwood could get to me, and he would have had Serona and the patrons at the Three Broomsticks not intervened.
This is grave news indeed. If Ranrok's goblins and dark wizards are after you, they want what we found in that vault.
Speaking of the vault, do you think that Ranrok is working with any of the goblins at Gringotts?
I do not. Gringotts goblins aren't typically the friendliest of beings, but they have a great deal of integrity. No, I dare say after what happened to that poor banker, the goblins at Gringotts are no followers of Ranrok.
They're after the locket. You said you discovered something in it.
Yes, yes. I discovered an inscription. When I read it aloud, this map appeared. Clever enchantment. It's a map of Hogwarts, to be sure, but I do not know where it leads.
It leads to the library. The restricted section, to be precise, and a bit beyond. I see traces of magic there on the map.
I suspected you would see something.
Shall we go?
I appreciate your enthusiasm, and I'm eager to discover what we may find there as well, but... if our experience at Gringotts, let alone what happened to Miriam, taught me anything, it's that the path we're on is terribly dangerous. I'd like you to work with Professor Hecate a bit, before we continue.
But sir, how dangerous could the library be? Perhaps we're only after a book.
Perhaps we are only after a book, but we should be prepared for anything. Once you've honed your defensive magic further, come and see me. I'll let Professor Hecate know to expect you.
Revelio. Revelio.
If only a new student were to help me with my sad predicament.
Are you all right?
Don't you know who I am? Zenobia Noak, the girl whom everyone at school hates for no reason.
Everyone hates you? Why?
Because Hogwarts is full of bullies and spoilsports. Leander Pruitt's one of the worst, that no-talent moon mind. I wanted to make some new friends, and so I brought my collection down to the common room. My gobstone collection, that is. I was hoping someone would want to play. Are you familiar with gobstones? Little balls, like marbles. Grand game. And if you lose, they spray you with a foul-smelling liquid.
I haven't much interest in a game that sprays you with odors.
Only if you lose, which I never do. Or at least, not often. People can be so cruel. Just because they're sprayed all over with smelly gobstone spit, it's their own fault for losing. Imelda is one of the worst losers. Everett and Astoria are terrible as well. And now those poor losers have taken my gobstones and hidden them in very high places all over the school.
Rather an overreaction on their part.
I'll say. Anyway, I can't work out how to get them back on my own. I don't think I know the necessary spells yet. I need someone... perhaps a selfless and talented fifth year to help me.
Haven't you any friends at school?
Not really. Natty said hello once, but not a word since.
Do you have any suggestions on how to get your gobstones down from their hiding spots?
If I knew that, I'd get them myself. Whoever hid my gobstones that high got up there somehow.
I'll see what I can do.
I'd appreciate the help. If you do find all of my gobstones, do come and see me again. I'll be back to playing Snake Pit and Jackstone by myself in no time.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Accio! Well, that's one of Zenobia's gobstones. I hardly see what all the fuss is about.
Revelio!
Can accidentally dropped a flobworm down my room.
Someone passed me a nosy glass with a heart on it.
Why would Slytherin put his common room in the dark? So dreary.
People are always fussing about in my common room. Someone will find it.
This charm on a Ravenclaw fourth year, so they couldn't answer the riddle.
Hogwarts hasn't been the same since. Lucky for us, we have Professor Weasley.
I think there were doxy eggs as well.
Better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Accio!
Revelio. I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Accio!
Upon Sir Cadogan if you ever require a champion of the realm.
Revelio. I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Accio! Revelio. I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Accio! Revelio! Revelio. Accio! That's the last of Zenobia's gobstones. I should go and see her.
What are you up to now?
Revelio.